Welcome to DM Podcast Takeaways. Gary Brecka starts by discussing the importance of understanding how to live a healthier, happier, and longer life, addressing common health challenges like weight gain, brain fog, lack of focus, and poor sleep quality. He highlights the role of methylation, which is essentially nutrient deficiencies in the body, as a common factor in these health issues. Using an analogy from his grad school days studying plant botany, he compares treating health issues to treating a rotting palm leaf by addressing the soil's nutrient deficiency, emphasizing the need to address underlying deficiencies in the body rather than just supplementing randomly. He criticizes the current approach to health, noting that people often prioritize their businesses over their health, even though health is the foundation of everything. He emphasizes the importance of getting basic data on one's body to create a roadmap for supplementation, focusing on essential amino acids, fatty acids, and minerals. He suggests that everyone should start with these basics and then move on to more specific testing, like a genetic methylation test, which provides information on how the body converts raw materials into usable forms. Stephen Bartlett raises a question about feeling broken due to deficiencies, to which Gary explains that it's not about being born broken, but about the body not functioning optimally. He delves into the intricate processes of the human body, highlighting the role of methylation in converting nutrients into usable forms and how gene mutations, like the MTHFR gene mutation, can impact this process. Gary emphasizes the importance of understanding how your body processes nutrients and suggests focusing on biomarkers like glycemic profile, hormones, and basic nutrient deficiencies as a starting point for health assessment. He also stresses the need for a genetic methylation test to further personalize supplementation and address deficiencies effectively. Gary explains that individuals with trauma may have a heightened response to stress due to the relationship between trauma and the activation of the fight or flight response mediated by catecholamines like norepinephrine and dopamine. He discusses how a gene mutation can affect the breakdown of catecholamines, leading to individuals either quickly breaking down these neurotransmitters, fast CoMT, or being slower to break them down, slow CoMT. Those with the slow CoMT gene mutation may experience persistent anxiety and worry as their minds remain active, especially at night, leading to disrupted sleep and an inability to fall asleep due to overthinking. This heightened state of alertness and anxiety is not necessarily tied to external triggers, but can be a result of the body's internal chemistry, influenced by genetics and past experiences. Gary emphasizes the role of nutrient deficiencies, particularly B vitamins, in regulating catecholamines. He suggests that addressing these deficiencies can help normalize catecholamine metabolism and manage anxiety. Additionally, Brecka discusses the importance of vitamin D3, highlighting its role in immune function and overall health. He argues that understanding these nutrient deficiencies, hormone imbalances, and glycemic control can significantly impact an individual's performance and well-being, suggesting that supplementing deficiencies could lead to optimal health and potentially alleviate symptoms of anxiety and other mental health issues. Gary talks about his interactions with high-profile individuals and reflects on his career journey, highlighting significant personal and professional changes. He mentions working with celebrities like Dana White, Steve Harvey, Stephen A. Smith, Steve Aoki, and Kendall Jenner. Despite this, Gary emphasizes that his work is not solely focused on celebrities but aims to educate and inspire the general public, particularly those interested in biohacking. He discusses the changes in his life since gaining more visibility, noting the increased scrutiny and pressure that comes with it. Gary acknowledges that while competition for attention in the wellness space is fierce, his goal remains to provide valuable, accessible information to a wide audience. He expresses a desire to move away from the desire to impress others with his knowledge and instead focus on delivering meaningful content that can positively impact people's lives. Gary then shares a personal story from his previous career, where he felt restricted in helping individuals due to legal constraints. He describes his role in predicting life expectancies for life insurance companies, which involved analyzing extensive personal data. Despite feeling a sense of connection to the people he studied, he was often unable to intervene in their lives to prevent negative health outcomes. This experience was a catalyst for him to pursue a career in wellness, where he could directly impact people's health and well-being. Overall, Gary's story is one of transformation and purpose. He has shifted from a career focused on data analysis to one centered around helping others live healthier, happier lives. His experiences have shaped his perspective on health and wellness, driving him to make a positive impact on individuals' lives every day. Gary Brecka reflects on his past mistakes, particularly quoting articles instead of research earlier in his career, and emphasizes the importance of simplifying messages. He highlights a 2018 study from the Journal of Headaches and Face Pain, which found a direct inverse relationship between sodium intake and migraine headaches. Gary explains that low sodium levels, often due to factors like sauna use, exercise without remineralization, or drinking filtered water without remineralization, can lead to nutrient deficiencies and migraine headaches. He recommends monitoring sodium levels and remineralizing with sea salt to potentially alleviate migraines. He also discusses the importance of addressing deficiencies in the human body rather than focusing solely on pathology, citing examples from his experience with a large database of gene tests. Gary emphasizes the need to look at modifiable risk factors and nutrient deficiencies that can lead to diseases. He criticizes the current healthcare system in the United States, which spends a significant amount on healthcare yet lags behind in various health indicators like infant mortality rate and life expectancy. Gary suggests simple practices to improve health, such as drinking mineralized water, taking omega-3 supplements, and developing a morning routine that includes sunlight exposure and grounding. He explains the concept of grounding, where touching bare soil or grass allows the body to exchange ions with the earth, potentially improving blood cell health and overall well-being. Brecka also discusses PMF mats as a way to achieve similar benefits indoors. Overall, he advocates for a holistic approach to health that considers environmental factors, nutrient deficiencies, and lifestyle choices. Stephen and Gary discussed several health practices, including the use of PEMF mats and breathwork. PEMF mats, when used, can lead to a more alkaline blood pH. Gary highlighted the importance of breathwork, particularly mentioning Hypermax, a device based on Nobel Prize-winning work by Dr. Van Arden and Dr. Otto Warburg. This device allows for breathing 95% oxygen for 10-12 minutes during activity, promoting oxygenation. Gary emphasized the significance of engaging auxiliary respiratory muscles to ensure oxygen reaches the lungs' depths, especially as people age and tend to breathe more shallowly. He noted the importance of keeping small promises to oneself, like maintaining a consistent morning routine, as it boosts self-confidence. They discussed red light therapy's benefits, known as photobiomodulation, which reduces inflammation, improves circulation, and enhances mitochondrial function. Gary mentioned personal experiences and anecdotal evidence, such as Joe Rogan's improved eyesight and skin after using red light therapy. Regarding sunlight exposure, Gary recommended the first 45 minutes of sunlight for its positive effects on circadian rhythm and sleep. He explained how light influences hormones like cortisol and melatonin, suggesting that morning light exposure can improve sleep quality. Regarding hydrogen water, Gary expressed a strong belief in its benefits, citing numerous studies on hydrogen's role in reducing inflammation and improving various health markers. He demonstrated a hydrogen water generator, explaining how it infuses hydrogen gas into water under pressure, creating a highly concentrated solution. Overall, Gary and Stephen's conversation covered various health practices and their potential benefits, emphasizing the importance of consistent routines, sunlight exposure, and innovative therapies like PMF and hydrogen water for optimal health. Stephen and Gary discussed the increasing popularity of Ozempic, a peptide called semaglutide used for type 2 diabetes and obesity. Gary mentioned another peptide called tirzepatide, which performed better in trials. He cautioned about side effects like paralytic gut and advised combining these peptides with weight training to preserve lean body mass. Gary shared his fulfillment in his current life, feeling like he's living someone else's life because he loves what he does. He emphasized the joy of engaging with intellectual minds and the gratitude he feels for his success. Regarding the challenges, Gary mentioned the difficulty in maintaining individual interactions with people seeking his help due to his growing popularity. He expressed a desire to support more people through trained professionals to meet the overwhelming demand. Gary also discussed the impact on his family, highlighting his children's success and their involvement in his work, which he finds incredibly rewarding. He expressed gratitude for the time he gets to spend with them. The conversation also touched on the importance of community for health and longevity. Gary explained how isolation can significantly impact life expectancy, citing the broken heart syndrome, where the loss of a companion can lead to a decline in health and, in some cases, death. He emphasized the interconnectedness of cells within the body, highlighting the importance of community even at a cellular level. Stephen and Gary delved into the impact of loneliness and isolation on life expectancy. Drawing from animal studies and personal observations, they discussed how moving loved ones into assisted living facilities or being isolated from family can dramatically affect mortality rates, particularly in the elderly. Gary emphasized the importance of community and purpose, sharing his own experience after selling his company. Despite appearing in public with celebrities, he spends most of his time with his family and a small, trusted team, which he finds essential for his well-being and work. The conversation shifted to retirement and purpose, with Gary mentioning a probabilistic factor for retirement and communal interaction. He highlighted the significance of purpose in longevity, citing examples from blue zones where the elderly remain active and engaged in daily life. Gary expressed frustration with limitations in the life insurance industry, particularly the inability to communicate with patients or their physicians directly, which he felt could sometimes lead to missed opportunities for improving health outcomes. Later, Stephen shared the results of a genetic test focused on methylation genes, which are crucial for converting raw materials into usable forms in the body. Dr. Carrie Sarda explained the results, noting that Stephen had one variant gene, which could affect his ability to detoxify, fight inflammation, and regulate mood and sleep. She emphasized the importance of addressing this gene variant through supplementation. Gary elaborated on the methylation process, using an analogy of passing sandbags down a line to explain how gene variants can impact the entire pathway. He highlighted the significance of the MTHFR gene, which is early in the methylation cycle and can affect downstream genes. Dr. Sarda discussed the practical implications of these gene variants, such as sleep issues, mood disorders, and gut problems, but noted that these could be managed through targeted supplementation. The conversation concluded with Gary expressing his desire to see people live healthier, happier, and longer lives, pledging to continue spreading his message to achieve this goal. Stephen thanked Gary for his impactful advice, noting the positive feedback he had received from listeners about their improved lives due to Gary's insights. This is it for today. Thank you all for tuning in to DM Podcast Takeaways. If you found this summary insightful, please consider subscribing to our channel for more engaging content.